So what's going on, guys? Today we're going to be talking about an app that I was a bit skeptical about at the start, but that has dramatically changed the way I use my laptop or computer every day. I want to share that app with you, but before, I want to tell you a little bit of the story behind it. So as you guys already know, I've been a fan of an app called Super Whisper for the most part of a year now. It's a voice-to-text transcription app, and I use it for pretty much everything, including my work and just regular stuff that I do on a day-to-day basis. So when the app creator, Neil, released this new app, or actually bought this app and re-released it, I guess, this app called Homerow, I instantly was paying attention to it. But my first impressions were not that good, to be honest. So I didn't give it a try for, I don't know, about 3 months. But I was entirely wrong. I ended up loving Homerow, and I think you would love it too. So let's have a look at it. All right, guys, so this is Homerow. And as you can see, the idea behind this app is extremely simple. You just get a keyboard shortcut for every button that it exists on your macOS ecosystem. Now, if you're not familiar with shortcuts, I love shortcuts. I have shortcuts for pretty much everything. So if I want to get into my planner, I'm just like one shortcut away. If I want to get into my website, I'm one shortcut away. Slack, same thing. It's like every app, every main app that I use uses a shortcut so that I can get there instantly. And I have a lot of other shortcuts as well using Alfred and other kinds of just applications. But you still need to use your mouse once in a while. You know, if you're here navigating, let's say on Arc, my main browser, then I'll need to move my mouse around to actually get to my email, which is in the top left, for instance. But with Homerow, you're just a couple of button presses or keyboard presses away. And this is how the app works. So let me show you a demo of how that would look in action. Just by pressing a regular shortcut, you get an overlay over every existing button that you can see in whatever screen you're looking at. So in this case, you see that I'm on my browser and I get buttons everywhere, or at least keys or combinations of keys. So in this case, if we're looking at my Gmail, which is in the top left, I know that I have to press D and E to use that click or that button shortcut, which is extremely useful. And let me do that for you right now. D, E, I'm on my Gmail. Let's say I want to get back to my tab, so I can just press it again. And in this case, it will be S, J, H, and I'm back to the Homerow tab. So that's how it works, simply in kind of fast action. You just get a keyboard shortcut for everything. And let's take a look at that in other ways. I want to use another tab, for instance. I'm going to go to the Adobe Express tab. Simple as that. You can even go navigating inside of the websites as well, right? So this is going to load up for me, and that will give me more options for my keyboard presses. So I want to do the icon on the top left. I can just do that. I want to scroll down in this page, and that's another thing that this app, Homerow, will let you do. It will also let you scroll as if you were scrolling with your mouse anywhere where you can scroll. So in this case, if you look at this screen, I have two ways of scrolling. I have my left tabs where I could scroll potentially those, or I have the main screen with the Adobe Express where I could scroll as well. So the way to scroll is using another shortcut with Homerow, and I get to choose what parts of the screen do I want to scroll. So for instance, if I want to scroll the main one, it would be three, I think. So yeah, you can see it's selected. So if I just press one key on my keyboard, I get to scroll down, I get to scroll up, I get to scroll down even faster or up even faster just by pressing shift. Incredible, you know? If I want to change where I'm scrolling, I just press tab and then I get my, you see my tabs here? Well, if I had more tabs, I could scroll more, but I can open a folder, for instance. Let's open this folder up. And now I have a way more scrolling here. So I'm going to open again the scrolling shortcut, press 4, and I get to scroll through my tabs again. And throughout this whole process, I'm not touching my mouse at all, which is just crazy for me. So you can do it anywhere on your website, on your browser, or on other apps. Let me go ahead and show you another app, for instance. Let's do Notes. So I'm going to open up my Notes app just by using Homerow again. And then I'm going to scroll down here by pressing 3 and scrolling through all of my notes. And this is just amazing stuff right here. You can see I get to press inside of my notes also just by pressing shortcuts. Here are some just short ideas that I've been thinking about. And I get to return to my website, to my browser, and do it all over again. So this app is just amazing for that kind of stuff. I think there's a couple of problems that it's solving. The first one is just being a huge time saver. So you don't have to use your mouse at any point. You're going to keep your hands on the keyboard. And that likely means that you'll be faster in whatever it is that you're doing that doesn't require precise editing. Most of the time, for me, it really takes a couple of clicks to get to where I want to go. And I'm thinking it should be the same for you. The exception to this rule would be if you're editing text or something that requires precise cursor action. Maybe that's when you will actually need your mouse. But if not, it's likely that you only are one or two clicks away from wherever you need to be to continue your work. So it's saving you time between just switching from your keyboard to your mouse, which is actually amazing. The second problem, though, and I think the one that excited me the most when I started to play around with it for a longer time, it's that it's really helping my hand to not get tired. See, when I use my mouse all day, like this mouse right here, this is the Apple mouse specifically, and I use it because it's great for traveling, right? It's so small, so lightweight, so I use it a lot, but it's horrible for your ergonomics. So most of the time when I'm scrolling through a page, you can see there's no scroll wheel here, so I really have to get my finger there in a really awkward way. And just not using my mouse to scroll and being able to use my keyboard is already saving me a ton of issues, or actually a ton of pain in my hand. And the same goes for the ergonomic position of resting your wrists in your keyboard or on your keyboard versus using a mouse. For me, I think it's way more comfortable to use your keyboard most of the time than reaching for your mouse and just having your hand resting there in a kind of unnatural way. So it just makes me feel more comfortable while working, and that has been the big, big plus that I found using this app. So with that being said, as you can see on the screen here, Homerow is a buy once, use forever kind of thing. And to be honest, I haven't even bought it yet because I feel like I don't need to at this point. You get 50 free shortcuts every time before you get a prompt telling you to buy a license, and the prompt goes away like with one keyboard shortcut press. So Neil is being extremely generous, just letting people try this app out. And of course, I think I'm going to buy a license at some point. But for now, it's been working amazing, even in the free kind of version or trial, whatever you want to call it. So just go and try it out. Man, I promise you'll change your life if you actually get accustomed to using all these little keyboard presses to get where you want to go. And it's not that hard. I thought it was going to be. That's why I didn't try it for a while. And it's just changed my life forever. So Homerow, great app. Go try it out. It's totally free to use, as I already told you. You'll not feel any difference between the paid version if you're just starting out. And I think you'll be one of those apps that you can't live without. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope you got some value out of it. Go try the app out. And also, don't forget to subscribe, like the video if you got anything useful out of it. And I'll catch you soon with another video. I'm Fernando, signing off.